Hey guys, your broker repairs, and welcome back to my FIFA. This is Team Liverpool promo where the last time I left off. I'm not tell you, but I'll say one thing. It was epic. That's all I'll say. Hey, what was so epic? Why was it so epic? It's so epic. You're gonna have to go and watch to see for yourself. In this episode, I have a quarterfinal in the League Cup against Bournemouth. We're looking for that spot in the semi-final for come the new year. And of course, since this is a cup game, the second team is out. But they like Samurai Moore and Shea Osho. Oh, and Diego Origi and all players.
Almost as quick when he hasn't got the ball, so that's a real threat here.
Yeah.
This is the Liverpool side.
So name drop Shea Osho. No, I'm pretty sure I didn't start him in this match. But even when he's not around in the main first team, he would be on the bench. So he's an integral part of the second team.
Looking good, this move.
Origi, he more can't get the aerial go off of the corner. Come on, and that, yes. Simon, Reyes, cunt, stepped in just as I was getting ready for a goal from Mark Clavin in this career mode.
And you in.
Oh, good boy, Diawara. What was that? It's terrible. Moment that, yes. More.
He's coming forward with some danger.
Pass. Mensah! There we go. There's the opening. Oh, Fusa Mensah. Celebrating his being offered a new contract. Heck, he did ask for more money recently. He actually accepted it. I know I offered him one. I'm trying to remember if he's accepted it, yeah, or not. Anyway, he's either celebrating signing a new contract or celebrating being offered a new contract. With a rare goal. That's only like his fourth or fifth goal since joining the club.
That had equalizer written all over it. Well, when you see him this season, he's finished harder chances than that. I don't think he can believe
it. The surprise signing in January last season. There's more. Still has them. Oh, Alexander Arnold places that with pristine precision. And it was I passed it behind Origi, but Alexander Arnold says, "Not to worry, I'll stick it right in there." And that is a top quality finish. Third goal of the competition.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. Foncia. Football between these two. Nice passing. Fraser.
Nice 2-0 lead all of a sudden. Because that second goal came right after the first. It was a misery compiler If I've seen one. Might be more in this game. Here is more. Add more. Okay, I'll stop saying that.
Right back. Now Wisdom. Fraser. Foncio. Nice return pass.
Also, I wanted to talk to you guys about something. I don't know if any of you guys know this. I don't know if it's true. I just want to see if anyone can clarify if it's true or not. And my comments are still off, and they will forever remain off. But, you know, I have Twitter. Tell me that.
Well, he's had a go.
Well, if you don't buy a ticket, as they say.
Men say your confidence is just a little bit too high. You know, freaking cool your jets, dude. You're not a top quality striker. You're Sarah Duffins admit. Anyway, yeah. Apparently, Emre Moore, his surname is apparently said Mar.
Was absolutely on top of his game. The break is definitely on.
They don't say Moore, they say Mar, apparently. I don't know this to be true. I can't. Like I said, I don't know if this is true. Boy, if anyone can clarify, please let me know on Twitter. Her link is in the description in case you're not aware. It's at Corey Pierce 4. Moore or Mar. Knocks in after the Origi shot was spilled by the keeper. Well, more parried than spilled.
Liverpool really on top form in their first half.
That gives me a comfortable 3-0 lead going into the towards the end of this first half and going into the second half. Fine, there's no goals in this first half.
Another turnover in play here with that interception. That's going to run on through to the goalkeeper. High class first half performance.
This is wait, did I see Hull were playing Newcastle? Huh. That's ironic. That was a quarterfinal in the real life EFL Cup this season, which Hull won on penalties. After ended 1-1. I mean, it was Newcastle's own fault. They had the match won, but they decided, you know what, let's not defend after going 1-0 up and pretty much instantly conceded the equaliser. Penalty. Hello?
Was.
Referee! Yeah. Oh, that's the way it is? I know the score. Or why did I try that? Anywho, yeah,
good feel about it.
Stroke of coincidence, if I've ever seen it. That the same two teams get paired up in real life and in the game. Only the game is paired up one season later.
Got his shot off now. Good save. They line up for the corner.
Savio. One. Three. Fair.
For a shot, maybe. It goes out
Henry.
Wide again. Good strong tackle. Referee had a good look.
Alfori. throw. Let's make a substitution or two, make an alteration. I'm gonna bring on Moya for Mar or more. I'll bring on Shayoja since I mentioned him earlier. And I'll keep up giving Lopez some time in the shine.
Alan, they're going to make the substitution. He's coming off, and he's done very well today.
Yeah, you can't point to many
mistakes. That was almost a combination goal. Oh! Almost ended up being a loose immense a brace.
Now it's going to add to the thrills of a few spills, possibly.
Well, it normally does, doesn't it?
The throw almost led to the ultimate substitution link goal. Because the throw was taken by A. Lopez. The throw was thrown. It was given straight to Ushie Ojo, who whipped it in. And if the ball had gotten to Moya, who it was heading towards,
attacking well here
in the middle, and it would have been 4-0. And that would have been what I deem the ultimate
crosses in
substitute link goal. And why I call it that is because it has all three of your the substitutes you can make in a non-friendly game. Involved in one fluid motion to score a goal. And it was almost all their first touches as well. It was Lopez and Ojo's first touch, but it never got to Moya, which is why it's still 3-0.
Baba, he's coming forward with some danger.
Riggy. Good block by Mings to prevent the shot getting on target. Lopez! However, a hell of a goal.
Check on the corner count. I don't think the corner was supposed to go there because it went straight. The shot's on!
Laurie! Everyone's having a pop.
7 more minutes to go. 3-0 now, almost over.
Riggy.
Impact on the next game, Alan.
Well, Liverpool go up against.
Now the shot!
Oh, Moya puts it way wide.
I'm sure.
Maybe I should have taken a touch instead of hitting that. Life is full of ifs and buts, isn't it?
A damaged muscle here, it might be a pull, it might be out for some weeks.
Idiots.
We go back to the goalkeeper here and does. 4 minutes still to come of added time. Onto the attack now. There's another one.
Well, the defence in front of him, Martin, has been totally dominant, and as a result, well, he's had his slippers on, hasn't he, out there?
Through pass.
Shayojo. Whoopsie. What am I even saying? Oh, I hate getting tongue-tied.
He's not let the ball escape his grasp.
There's the full-time whistle. 3-0 win. Holy shit. Extra time, 2-2. Where are the odds it goes to penalties and Hull win, but Hull won anyway, so And the other quarterfinals, Manchester United lost to Birmingham, and Manchester City defeated Sheffield Wednesday. So City, Birmingham, Hull, and Liverpool are your semi-finalists for this year's
English League Cup quarterfinal. Hull City
Cup.
Newcastle United 2 after extra time. Liverpool 3, Bournemouth 0.
I played Manchester City in both the League Cup final and the FA Cup final last season. What odds I faced them in what would be technically 3 consecutive finals? Because I don't count that Community Shield bullshit against Chelsea. Even though I won it, I don't count it. Come on, what are the odds? I'm going to say I get Manchester City in the next round of the in the semi-final. Is this sorry, I'm not experimenting. Ah, I was kind of afraid of this. To be honest, I wasn't really expecting him to just sit around and wait for his opportunity. I kind of had the feeling he would say, you know, enough's enough. Well, hey, I did get Manchester City. So the final won't be 3 consecutive finals against Manchester City. It'll be a final against either Hull or Birmingham. So it could be 7th place Hull or Championship Birmingham. Look at Manchester City. They struggled last season as well. Look at them this season. 15th. And only 3 points ahead of Middlesbrough in the third relegation spot. That makes no sense, and yet Crystal Palace are sitting there in second place. What? Man, the Premier League. So unpredictable. So, not interested in listening to the results of the Brighton game or the Middlesbrough game. Manchester United, the only game I have any vested interest in, because they're technically still in the title race. It's not much of a title race. In fact, this is exactly what happened last FIFA as well. The second season was the easiest one. Every other team seemed to just take each other out, and I strolled to the title. Even when I won the title last season, with winning every single game, I didn't stroll to it. Chelsea, he pushed me for a majority of the season. I could win his league way earlier this season, with the way it's going. I mean, when the closest team to me after 13 games is 11 points behind, that says a lot. That's 4 games Crystal Palace would need to lose and then to win in a row to get the top spot.
Top scorers.
Yeah, these home fans have been treated to some fantastic football.
Nah, they don't plan to start losing games.
Big reshuffle to Liverpool. Lloris Karius is the goalkeeper today. David Alaba starts with Nathaniel Clyne as the wide defenders. Mahmoud Dahoud plays with Emre Can in central midfield. And the strike force, Sadio Mane, joins up front with Daniel Sturridge.
Team beats me, they're going to have to beat better. So far, that's not been the case.
Federico Fernandez replaces Jordi Amat, who's been out of sorts lately. Ki Sung Jung comes in for Leroy Fair, who's been out of sorts lately. Rafa Timpi Gomi.
Team here. Mane. Nathaniel Clyne! Why did I shoot that? Just dipped it into the box and get someone on the end of it.
Read the play well to intercept. A massive run that they're on and just want to keep it going today.
Well, you look throughout the side and it's full of top class performers and full of players just exuding confidence.
The goal, but they still got the ball. Good defending. It's gone out.
Wait, it's out for a goal kick.
Joel Matty.
Coutinho.
Attacking well here. There goes
gets the ball back. Sturridge. 1-0. There it is. There's the opening goal. Celebration is called riding the wave, because we are riding the wave. It's called momentum. And it's a non-stop of juggernaut, a train like fucking wave. 18 Premier League was this season for Daniel Sturridge. I think that puts him like 2 behind Mane. I don't know for sure. I don't know how much Mane has. That might put him ahead of Mane. I don't know. Boy, how many goals did these two score? It's crazy and hard to keep up. Unless this somehow goes in, you know, all is equal to it. Well, the best as he could.
Firmino!
Off the bar from Firmino! Oh! Alaba! A rare open.
What's their lead now to
play go pull for Dana Alaba. And it's 2-0.
Came close to goalkeeper, actually.
The ball fell to him. And he slotted it at home. In off the toes of the goalkeeper. Fantastic.
So much space. Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
I mean, Alaba is still 100% from penalties this season, but that's 2 goals he's scored from open play. I think that's 5. That might even be 6 goals this season.
Well, it's out for a corner.
Considering he only scored 1 in all the games he played last season, that was in the semi-final of the FA Cup. Mane! He is onside. That is fucking bonkers. Swansea clearly don't give a shit about playing freaking offside track. Mane, freaking Akers is hoping the ball would fall to him, and as if it's like a freaking early Christmas present for him. Oh, okay. So that goal for Sturridge put him level with Mane, but that goal for Mane was his 19, so Mane is back in the lead. See? Unbelievably confusing. Hey, it offers an extra layer of intrigue. It's the closest race in the Premier League at the moment, because there's no title race to speak of.
Corner.
He has four games, Crystal Palace, need me to lose. Yeah, they're not starting today. 3-0 up on Swansea, I'm not playing this go. Shan.
Attacking now.
Sturridge. Penalty! Dava Alaba will have the chance to get his second goal of the game. Interestingly enough, there he is. Beautiful penalty. The perfect penalty from the Austrian right back. Left back, sorry. Not sure why I said right back.
And he showed it there, really.
Hammered home. And he's still perfect from the penalty spot in Liverpool colours. I know he has two open play goals. That makes five successful penalties this season, and six if you include the one he scored last season. Alaba is just freaking unbelievable from penalties. I mean, he only has like 86 or something, which, you know, isn't the highest. I mean, it's... Actually, wait, am I thinking of his... I know he has the highest penalties on the team, which is what he takes.
Into the attacking third. Probing away. Defender to it first.
I know. Oh, for a fact that,
this could be a chance.
These penalties aren't the highest, but when you have 100% increase, you know, from them, you're quick. You regularly take the penalties for. You can't disagree with that. I mean, it's only been 6-6, which, you know, it's not bad considering. I mean, it's not. Well, I mean, no one gets a penalty every single game. Oh, wow! Norwich are beating Manchester United! Yeah, see? What did I tell you? There is no tie race. Manchester United are third or fourth, and are still technically in the tie race.
It's good work between these two.
They're gonna be an extra 3 points behind me. I'm winning 4-0, and they are currently losing 1-0.
Got the tackle in. Well, this is how this team can play. Sustained. Oh, he's through.
Sam, hey. Aw, the keeper shouldn't have come out. What was he thinking? In 20, he goes again for Sadio Mane's second Premier League season in a row. Oh. Well, you get 30+. Plus, it's quite possible if they're going to be as easy as that. Sturridge was calling for it, but I mean, I was going to chip the keeper all day, every day. Especially if he's coming out like that. I mean, that is just freaking retarded. Level of stupidity. I mean, he may as well have left the goal completely unattended if he wanted Mane to just knock it in. With most of ease.
Trying to find an opening. Not panicking. This is how they love to play on the break.
He's already learned his lesson. And it's in coming out. Ooh. My Chan. Not sure why I went for the, long ranger, but I did.
Gylfi Sigurdsson. And it's been an hour of very good football here. We've still got 30 more minutes to go, and I'm sure we're going to enjoy that as well. There's some potential in this move.
Gomez. Dyer! Oh! Oh, that's annoying. I wanted to get get the clean sheet, but it's not a bad goal from Dyer, I'll give him that.
Good stop by the goalkeeper.
Yeah, you've got one, you're not getting any more.
These days, going off your feet like that is running the risk of the referee taking serious action.
Well, he's dived in. It's a reckless one.
The pass not completed, really. He's got his shot off now.
Oof! He almost did get another. Fucking hell. No, wait, whoops. No, I'm not going park bus. Just because they scored and then come very close to getting another. Just keep banging and go, pulls in and it won't fucking matter. I mean, they score. Look, Sayamane hat trick. 21. And go, pulls. I mean, it's very possible that he might get double digits again.
What a day he's having. Three goals now. He's been a thorn in the side of the opposition all match, and he thoroughly deserves that hat-trick. Well, let's take another look at the goal. In this game, the scoreline is 6 goals.
I mean, double digits. He's already in double digits. He's way in double digits. I mean, 30-plus goals again.
Timbe Gomi.
Slip of that time.
On the attack here. Challenges for the ball. Now Sadio Mane. Now they've got a free kick here.
Really? Mane is adjudged to have fouled Fernandes as he was trying to get the ball from him. I think now is a good time, mate, to make the substitutions. Instead of, let's stick off to him anyway. He's got his hat trick. He's no reason to stay on this, like, he's going for another goal. You know what? No, I'll take off. I'll take off Mata. Why not?
Looking down at the Swansea bench.
It's not like it matters.
Substitute brought on. Moving forward. Now the shot!
Oh, and Daniel Sturridge gives us a parting gift of another goal. He's going to be pissed when he sees his number going up, especially now.
Goalkeeper was reaching for it, and it did actually touch him on the way in.
Oh, I didn't decide to take Mane off. No, wait, I did take off Mane. Hey, Sturridge was staying on. Oh, my bad. Oh, it's definitely one of those days, ladies and gentlemen.
Just a little nudge to nudge you in the direction of what's coming up on EA Sports for you. Our coverage of the Premier League fixture for Swansea City. They'll be hosting Norwich City.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Shots on here.
Are you fucking kidding me? I can see two in the game for the first time ever. Fuck!
Defenders managed to get in the way. It's not really going to get the better of him from that range, especially when he can see it all the way. Well, just over 84 minutes gone, 6 minutes left on my watch. Jack Cork.
It's the first time in like a really long time.
Nathan Dyer. Good forward play from them. Free kick in these closing minutes.
Now my frustration is getting me.
And the Liverpool man has got yellow here.
I think he left the referee.
Swansea shouldn't have that second goal.
Defender to it first.
Get rid of it. I will fucking trash this game if they get another.
3 minutes, that's what's going to be played for added time.
Rivet, Nathaniel. No. Not like that, no. Oh, that is the opposition player. Don't hit it straight into him.
Good progress with this attack. Jack Cork. Gylfi Sigurdsson. And here's the shot.
Goalkeeper hangs on.
There's a full-time whistle. 7-2. It's not a 7-2 game, to be honest. It wasn't a 7-2 game, I should say. Manchester United, they salvaged a point, but all that does is mean they dropped 2 points.
Accrington Stanley, 0.
And despite the fact that I didn't concede 2 goals, I scored 7. Unfortunately for Manchester United, that means I go 2 more points into that gap up between me and them. And they're not even in second place.
2, Peterborough United, 2. Mansfield Town.
So remind me again why I have to call this a tie race? Because I'm pretty sure it's not. It's a non-existent one. It doesn't exist.
Oldham Athletic, 1. Rotherham United, 3. Rochdale, 1. Bradford City, 0. Swindon Town, 2. Bristol Rovers, 2. Walsall, 3. Scunthorpe United, 0. Wickham Wanderers, 2. Plymouth Argyle, 1. Brighton and Hove Albion, 0. Newcastle United, 1. Liverpool, 7. Swansea City, 2. Manchester
Swapping
City, 1. West Ham United, 0.
But, overall, it didn't matter. So, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.
At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 42 points. In second, Crystal Palace with 28 points. In third, Chelsea.